it going? I hope you're having a fantastic day. I have certainly been having... Oh!
Hi, Miku. This is Scarlett. Being true to who you are makes all your dreams possible.
Miku, Scarlett, I'm not Hatsune Miku. That was weird. Anyway, I thought I was getting like a fun birthday call from my best friend Scarlett Johansson, but I guess she got her wires crossed. Yeah, wrong, got the wrong cameo. Hi, I feel like it's been a bit. Hold on, how long has it been since I last streamed? Oh shit! It might actually have been like 2 weeks ago. Maybe a week and a half. Who knows? Anyway, it's been a while. I'm coming back to it. I swear to you. And in fact, I'm about at the point where I want to make a commitment that this Tuesday we are going to be back on normal schedule. I'm sincerely hoping I feel better by then. I guess I needed an extra week. I don't know. But we're not really here to talk about that right now. That's a whole thing. I've what's the phrase? Is hem and haw? Is that a thing? I've discussed at length about my brain and how it's not been at its peak last couple months. But you know what? I said mid to late August for a reason. It is currently still like mid August, I would say. We're right about to enter late August. Actually this week I would say is late August. We officially just last week passed the threshold. The threshold. I saw explosive say hemmed and hawed, and I said threshold. Break the threshold. Anyway, it is my birthday today. Thank you, by the way. Oh, I haven't even said thank you, everybody, so much for all of your kindness and all of your generosity, all the subs and everything coming in. I can't thank everybody individually because it's been coming in like crazy, but I really, really appreciate it. It means the world to me. And I have been having a pretty good couple of days. Because actually, you know, today's my birthday, but today actually wasn't even really the celebration of it. I went out with some friends last night to get some dinner, get a little birthday dinner. And then we went back to my friends Katie and Jordan's place, and we were supposed to go back and do like a one-off campaign of the My Little Pony tabletop RPG that came out this year. But dinner took so long that we ended up just going back and starting character creation. We didn't even finish. We just started it. But it was still a very fun time. And I made a character that I'm very much in love with. My character, she's not entirely figured out. She's another coffee pony. I already have a pony OC that's kind of like a coffee kind of gal. But I went in a slightly different direction because I've been rewatching Better Call Saul lately, past couple weeks. Great rewatch, as usual. I'm on like my seventh or eighth rewatch of that show. Since watching it for the first time a few years ago, and it just gets better. It just always gets better. There is never a point where I'm like, you know what, I'm enjoying this show less than I did the first time. No, it's always just fantastic. So I'm rewatching Better Call Saul yet again in that infinite Better Call Saul Breaking Bad El Camino rewatch cycle that I'm in, where I'll rewatch Breaking Bad, then I'll rewatch El Camino, then I'll rewatch Better Call Saul, and then I'll think, oh man, rewatching Better Call Saul has got me wanting to rewatch Breaking Bad. And so then I go rewatch Breaking Bad, and then I'm like, well, I gotta follow it up with the prequel, and then I go rewatch Better Call Saul again. And it's just an infinite loop. I am always, at any given moment, probably in the middle of a Breaking Bad, Better Call Saul rewatch. They are that special to me. I love those shows to death. Anyway, what was I gonna say? Oh yeah, so I've been rewatching Better Call Saul again, and it's got me, it's, you know, it's wormed its way into my brain as a brain worm does. And so my pony tabletop character currently, her current rendition is that she is named Goody Two Shots, and she is a barista, but her coffee shop is actually a bit of a front. She actually has achieved her barista and coffee shop success dubiously. And so she's got a little bit of like a Jimmy McGill kind of thing going behind the scenes. She's like her own little Slippin' Jimmy. And she's somewhat dishonest. But of course, we'll see how that develops over time. What's her cutie mark? Okay, I actually did think of this. I thought, I think her cutie, I haven't fully decided, but I think her cutie mark is going to be a latte. And the latte art is, you know, like the two like drama masks where you have like the happy face, sad face kind of thing. And you know, they're kind of like sitting next to each other. You know what I mean? That visual. And that would be the latte art in the cup. So I don't know. That was just the first idea that came to my mind. It's not final. What element does she represent? Oh yeah, this is so funny. Because when you play the My Little Pony tabletop RPG, the newest one, because apparently there's two. If you play the most recent one that just came out, it actually, on your character sheet, it's like, hey, you got to pick an element of harmony. Your character is an element of harmony. Pick one, right? And I was like, oh, shit. I was like, oh, that kind of goes again. Because Goody Two Shots is a little bit of a crook. Like, she's a little bit of a rascal. I don't know if she actually deserves to be an element of harmony. So I had to kind of pick one. And I was like, I don't know, laughter. Because then my thought was like, well, Jimmy McGill, you know, Chuck hates his guts because he makes people laugh and he's very funny and charismatic, right? And so I figured that was the best fit. So, you know, that kind of works out. Oh shit! Hold on. Hold the fuck on. Kira Cat just donated $500. Oh no. They said, oh fuck, happy birthday. As much as I'd love to do my yearly 1K donation, I bought a new computer and car this year, so I should be at least a little responsible. Love you, Penny. Oh my god, Kira, this is not an obligation. Thank you. I really appreciate that. Holy fuck. That is so generous. Thank you, sincerely. That just paid off my dang birthday presents to myself this year. I got myself a couple things, and you have essentially just bought them for me. Thank you so much. I appreciate that a ton. Oh man, that is truly, I don't know what to say. I'm gonna move on because I feel like I could sit here and thank you for hours about that, but thank you. Just know it, I, oh my god, that's insane. But yeah, so had a fun time last night, and as of today on the yes, it is, fuck you. Okay, all right, listen, whatever you need to tell yourself, but also it is greatly appreciated. Yeah, so I haven't done anything today is what I was getting to, because we actually, I had this celebration last night. Alien Banana, thank you so much for the $42 tip. I appreciate it. Hey, listen, here's the thing. Actually, real quick, before I continue what I was going to say, all the tips and all the subs, greatly appreciated. I'm not going to say don't send me money, right? Like, but as much as I do appreciate it, I do want to give you a little bit of a premonition, because right now I don't need this support right now. What I will ask, if you want to support me, maybe just like a maybe just hold on for a little bit, because in September, I'm going to be doing a subathon. At least that's the current plan. So rather than sending me like a big donation or a big thing of subs right now, maybe make sure you got one in the chamber. You know, don't put yourself in a compromised position now, because later on I'm going to have an ample opportunity for people to, you know, spoil me with subs and everything. because I've been meaning to do a subathon because I want to get my subs to 1,000 by the end of the year. That has been a goal for like 2 years in a row and I haven't done it yet. So I want to do a subathon. Yeah, the plan is currently, oh, now you say that. I didn't know people are going to pop off. I'm sorry. I forget that you're extremely generous on my birthday and always send these crazy things. But like I have the memory of a snail. Do you have birthday moments? Hi, baby. Hi, thank you. But yeah, so next month, the plan is to do a Snapcube September Spider-Man subathon, which is really, really fun to say and to write. I'm going to be playing shit ton of Spider-Man games all the way up to Spider-Man Miles Morales in a row, maybe in one continuous stream, maybe at the very least in one continuous week. We'll see what I can do in terms of the format and what spectrum and everything will allow. But I'm going to be playing a bunch of Spider-Man games, and the goal is to finish a bunch of them and end up finishing Miles Morales in preparation and in the interest of hype for Spider-Man 2, which I'm going to be doing a playthrough of in October when that comes out, October 20th, I believe. So yeah, if you want to, I recommend, obviously it's going to be a little bit, it's like at least a month away, I would say, this subathon. But if you want to, you know, you want to save some of your dollars now in the interest of being a part of the festivities later, I'm just throwing that out there. But of course, do what you're going to do. And of course, I appreciate all the support so much anyway. So yeah. Okay, the other thing I was going to say. Yeah, so today I'm taking it pretty low-key because we celebrated last night, had some fun with friends, all that. And so today, I've just been hanging out today. I haven't done anything today, and that's fantastic. That's great for me. But I did want to do a birthday stream because I try to do a birthday stream every year, even if it's nothing super, super big. And it has been a while since I streamed anyway, so I wanted to just go live, see how it goes. But lately, I have been obsessed with Final Fantasy XIV again, as is probably to be expected. I'm back on my bullshit. I made a new Tumblr. Ruskinator Rex, thank you so much for the gifted subs. I appreciate it. I made a Tumblr side blog. I don't know if y'all would be interested in that kind of thing, but in case you are, I made a Tumblr blog where I post my Final Fantasy XIV antics, if you are someone who plays and you like to see other people's Warriors of Light. The blog is pellapeach.tumblr.com. Here, let me show you the setup here. I believe this is the... Yeah, here we go. Yeah, so it's Pellapeach. Pellapeach.tumblr.com, where I post all kinds of little screenshots, and it's just everything Final Fantasy. So fun. Of course, if you don't follow my main Tumblr, that is Snaps Cube. So I do have the two blogs. So, you know, if you want to follow me in my regular antics, I've been playing a lot. This has kind of been like the thing I've been doing while I rest and get ready to start streaming again. This has been the thing, right? So tonight I'm going to keep up that energy. But I wanted to do something a little festive, a little birthday themed, rather than just like a bog standard Final Fantasy stream. So I thought it'd be very, very fun if I logged in and with my culinarian job made myself a birthday cake because there's a recipe in the game, I believe, for, I think it's a housing item. I don't think it's actually like a food item. I could be wrong. But there is a recipe in the game that you can make with Culinarian for a birthday cake. However, it is not a default recipe. You actually have to kind of go out of your way to get it a little bit. I don't know how hard it's going to be. If it turns out to be a lot easier than I think it may or may not be. If it turns out to be pretty easy, we can always fill time. If I feel like going any longer, we can always do something else. When we're done with that, I actually do have another idea that's really stupid, but I don't know. But Final Fantasy heads might enjoy it. If I end up going through with it. But you know, I can fill time elsewhere, but usually it ends up being the case that whenever I set out a goal to do something in this game and I'm like, oh, this will probably take an hour, it usually takes like 4. And I mean that in the best way possible. So, yeah, this should be fun. So let's get this started. And let's freaking go. I'm hanging out right here in my free company. Hold on, let me turn the sound back on. Oh, there we go. Hanging out here in my private quarters in my free company house. As you can see, I have all my funny posters on hand. And yeah, this is I have a mannequin here. I don't know exactly really how to best utilize these. I kind of just put any clothes that I had on me. Oh, we're doing the same. Whoa, that's weird. Crazy. Anyway. Yeah, I got all my friends on the walls, and then I also have my two children right here, front and center, right next to each other. And yeah, this is my current red mage look. However, of course, this is not the look of a chef. This is not the look of a proper culinarian who's going to be creating these wonderful cakes. Oh yeah, also meet Drippy. Drippy's new. I actually got Drippy from the same dungeon that I got this caster top. This caster top is like one of my new favorite glam pieces in the entire game. It is so cute. I grind the shit out of Matoya's Relics, which is a dungeon from, I think, host. No, it's regular Shadowbringers, I believe. Yeah, so it's from here. Let me show you. So if you want to grind for this top, Starry Midnight Sky, thank you so much for the tip. I appreciate it. So you go to Shadowbringers Dungeons, and it is a level 80 dungeon. So yeah, it is post Shadowbringers. Yeah, so it's Matoya's Relict. It is, it is hard. It is difficult to get, just so you know. The way the loot works in that dungeon is very irritating. Also, people are saying it's loud as usual. let me fix this. I don't know, man. Whatever. Here. Okay, I don't have the audio thing on. It's like, it sounds fine to me, but you know. I would say it's the song itself, very strong sounds. I literally, like, if you were looking at my audio levels right now, it is actually, it's kind of insane to think that it might be too loud, because scientifically, the numbers that I'm seeing right now, it's like, there's no way it's too loud. But I also know that sometimes the way it looks on the waveform is just inconsistent. Here. Anyway, we'll see. If it is too much of a problem, even in the VOD version, I can always just level in post. I can't stand that silly hero walk animation. Okay, I get why. It's very anime, oh no, I'm late for school, ooh-wah kind of energy. But also, I've kind of gotten used to it. And when I try out another another race and like look at their run animations, I kind of miss it. Like it's kind of grown on me, mostly just because I during my time playing the game, I think I've decided that Pella, which is the name of my character, Pella Peach, Pella is the most like Pella when she is either a Hira or a Viera. Which for the uninitiated, Hiras are basically humans, and Viera are like bunny girls, essentially, like big bunny women. But I think Midlander is where I'm feeling the most Pella right now. I will say, okay, I don't mind the run animation. What is a little silly to me even still is the jump animation. The primary jump animation is pretty silly. She's very like, yeah. But, you know, that's neither here nor there. How bunny women are we talking? Oh, let's go outside. Maybe we can find one here. Let's go back to Charlian. Oh, actually, I'm going to have to go to let's go to Mordona, because that's where we'll need to go anyway. Because the first thing I need to do to make this funny cake is I need to buy a master recipe book, which might actually, depending on how much it costs in terms of crafter scripts, might take the most time. Let's see if we can find a bunny woman, just so you can take a look. Oh yeah, Sophie right here is an NPC. These are the bunny women. They're fantastic. Anyway. Okay, so we are currently a red mage. We might, depending on, no, you know what? Let's, okay, so I'm playing on controller, obviously. This is my controller UI, and I've been working very hard on it. And I'm quite proud of it. I think it's generally kind of minimalistic in a way that I enjoy. I can bring chat on and off, but I shouldn't call attention to that because that is technically not in the vanilla game. Don't tell anybody. But you know, we don't talk about that. Yeah, ignore the car. Not important. That's just Final Fantasy 15. But I have the map right here in case I need to look at it. But of course, I have the mini map. Super huge over there in a fun way. Also, this is Rudy. Rudy's my chocobo. I love Rudy. Okay, so, but of course, red mages can't make cakes. But you know who can? A chef, baby. I forgot I had the little birthday crown. So we're gonna be our little, we're gonna be a funny birthday chef. This is the look that we're going for with Culinarian. Got the cute spring shorts, the little kind of Mary Jane shoes, not really though. Cute socks, all that, and of course the Culinarian's apron. So, as you can see, when I pull up the crafting log, I do not currently have, so birthdays in the Final Fantasy 14 universe are called name days. I do not currently have named ya, by the way. You can see my previous misspellings. I do not currently have name day cake unlocked. What the heck? Why is that? If I look up cake, I have all these other cakes too. I have Starlight cake. We have a cheesecake, which is fun. I could make any of these, but where is the dang birthday cake? Well, I'll tell you. Crafters have these things that they can get called master recipes, which you basically have to get by spending scripts, which is like a specific crafter gatherer currency that you earn by essentially doing like special crafts or special gathers that are somewhat difficult depending on your level, and you can turn them into a collectible appraiser who will say, hey, thanks so much, here are some scripts. So, as far as I know, we have to buy Master Recipe 3. And I don't know how much it costs. And I also don't know what kind of script it's going to be. Because I believe the purple scripts are a lot harder to get than the white scripts. You can get white scripts from doing like basically any collectible. The purple scripts, I think you can only get by doing the highest level collectible that you have, which might be pretty challenging for me because though my crafter is at level 90, which is level cap, I am not very well geared. I am not a well geared crafter at the moment. And also, as you can see in the upper right, I have not done all of my job quests for my crafters. I know, I'm ashamed. But let's just see. So, white script exchange. Oh no, wait, Master Recipes 1? Okay, oh, we might be able to get these with white scripts. Master Carpenter, Master Armor, Goldsmith, Culinarian. Okay, Master Culinarian 3 only needs 100 scripts. And we have 49, so that is not too shabby. Let's go ahead and see what we will need to turn in to get, this is gonna be a cakewalk for, you know, for lack of a better term, no pun intended. Or you know what? Pun entirely intended, why not? We could totally just do a rarefied grilled rail or something like that. Or we could just turn in like three like super easy level 50 to 60 recipes. Yeah. Okay. We wouldn't even need to do that many, honestly. Okay. This will not be difficult. You'd also go visit Amelian's. That is true. That is also true. I might go visit her anyway, just to say hi. To the children's other mother. Let's pick the easiest recipe. Just for ease of, I'm not looking to suffer right now. I want to make a birthday cake. That's all I want. And besides, I actually have no clue how difficult the birthday cake is going to be to make. It might be reasonably hard and or it might have some rare ingredients that I don't have. So we might have to like wait for something. I don't know. We'll see. So let's look up the recipe for rarefied Dalmel gratin. Okay, so we'll need Dalmel meat, Cyclops onion, Highland flour, Popoto, sour cream. Let's look at the raw materials list, and this should give us a decent idea. Yeah, okay. So we'll need Dalmel meat. I have no clue off the top of my head where a Dalmel would be, but we only need one. Oh, but we'll need to make like, I want to make two of these. So we'll need two Dalmel meat. We have plenty of Cyclops onions, thankfully. We'll need 10 Highland wheat, which should be easy. We'll need two Popotos. And we'll need 6 yak milk. Yak milk. Is that? Okay, that's not gathering. That's milk. So we'll have to. I wonder, could I buy this from somewhere? We'll figure it out. I'll have a. And anything that I need to like look up, I will gladly look up. I'm not against figuring things out through Google. Dalmels are giraffes. They're in the Sea of Clouds. Okay, thank you. I appreciate that. Okay. So, actually it'll tell me what I need if I want to make two. That's awesome. Wait, that's really, really good. Okay, so let me close out of these. Can I keep it going? Okay. I wonder if that'll stay up. I hope so. All right. So, I'm going to go ahead and get the stuff that I know I can just go ahead and get. So, I need to switch to botanist. Perfect. Got the titty outlook and everything. Great day, great day. Okay, let's go to Chocobo Forest. Oh, this should be a cakewalk. This is gonna be easy. Yes, thank you. Please stay on screen. Thank God. Oh, perfect. Oh, there's an unspoiled thing too. I could go grab that real quick. No, not that. See, now the game is too quiet for me. I literally can't hear shit right now. That's better. Okay. Whee! Oh, birthday balloons! This wasn't even intentional. This is just what the roulette gave me. Aw. I'm so happy. I'm gonna go to this unspoiled place first. Oh, I hope it's not too far. I just wanna get the special rare stuff whenever it's available. Cause these unspoiled locations. Happen like only at certain times of day. Here it is. Does Pella have the same name day as you? I think so, actually. I think in the menu I just picked like the equivalent to August 20th. Oh, a dark matter cluster. That's fun. Yeah. Pieces this large are quite rare. I'll grab that. Let's get two of these. One more. Then I think I can get one more of these. Let's do... Just grab an old world fig. Nice. Oh! Okay. Oh, I thought we could get one more. Okay. So let me... Let's see how... I hope this is the right node. We might be able to find weed over here. I have literally no idea what's going on, but I'm loving it. Just as a quick overview, essentially, I'm trying to gather ingredients to create a special recipe that will give me crafter money that I can use to buy a recipe for a cake, which I will then gather ingredients to craft as well, basically. So it's just gonna be a lot of like, we're just going around, we're going around the world, grabbing materials for things, and then crafting them. In the grander interest of getting to the point where I can make a birthday cake for myself. Is this will not have wheat. I don't know what I was thinking. This is not, okay. Where, oh, I think it was like, oh, it was over here. Oh yeah, Chocobo Forest, so we just gotta go south. Okay. Bike. Woohoo! I've been leveling botanist and miner recently, and I don't know why crafting and gathering is so fun in this game, but they are. It's super chill. I remember when I first got into this game, I mean, and you can, this happened on stream. You can literally go back in the archives on Snapcube 2 and watch these streams, but like, when I was first getting into this game, I would spend like fucking what felt like 6 hours at a time just crafting and gathering. At a certain point, like once I got into it, it was like, it's like a, like once you get into the gameplay loop of crafting and gathering, it's like a damn siren's call. It's so relaxing. Okay, here we go. Oh yeah, I've been here a few times. I've had to gather a lot of Highland wheat actually recently. Here we go. Okay, so we can enable quick gathering, but before we do that, let's make this easier on ourselves and do some damn King's Yield, which should give us extra. Did I do the right skill? Oh, I don't know if I did the right skill. Well, let's see. Okay, whatever. I mean, we'll just need to get 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so like two more nodes and we should have enough. Why is that shape there? What shape? Is this the right one? That's what I wanted. Oh, baby. Oh yeah, that'll do it. Do you mean Drippy? Drippy's my minion. They're cute little they're like essentially little toys that can follow you around. You just collect them. You just collect them as you play the game. Okay. Let's refresh. Okay, so we have more than enough island wheat. We need to get Popotos now. And then we'll just need to kill Dommels in the Sea of Clouds, I believe is where people said. And then Yak Milk, I assume, is something I can just buy. Yak Milk, I'll have to see where I can buy that from when the time comes. Popotos are in... Oh my god, this is even easier. This is an even lower level area. Oh, this is the easiest recipe of all time. I made the right choice. This means we'll especially have an easy time making it high quality, which will net us some bonus currency. Okay. I don't want to press circle when I have that thing highlighted. Why is the Popoto tooltip on screen? Oh, that's why. Stopped. No! Okay, that's fine. I actually remember what I need. It's just Popotos, Yak Milk, and Dommel Meat. No, it was south, I believe. South from here. She won't forget. I won't, I promise. Birthday balloons again! She promises, whoa. You said that exactly when I did. That's spooky. Alexa, you're starting to know me too well. Okay. Is the right one? Yes, perfect. Oh, yummy. I mean, it's just overkill at this point. We do not need that many Popotos. Actually, I think, yeah, that's, I think that's all. Where's the freaking... I don't know. I can just... This is not what I want. This is not what I plan. Collectibles, here we go. Yeah, that's more than enough. Oh, and we need the yak milk to make sour cream. Okay, that makes sense. All right, so let's go to... Let's go to... That fit is so cute. Thank you! I put... Oh, my island sanctuary! Oh, shit! Hold on, wait. Can I do a quick detour? I haven't done anything on my island sanctuary today. I have buildings that are done. Just a quick detour. My island. This will be fun. Okay. Let's do the island reveal for chat. Oh, they look so good! These buildings just got upgraded. Let's get the XP for that. Ichiro Hakubi, thank you so much for the sub. I appreciate it. Yeah. Oh, that was a decent chunk of XP. Not as much as I was hoping. I'm still gonna have to do a lot of material grinding, essentially. But okay, let's grab this one too. Actually, I have three of these buildings done. I wonder how my crops are doing. They're either done or they're not. Just a little prediction on my part. Call me a... I almost said call me Nosferatu, which is... That's not right. That's not correct. Don't call me Nosferatu. Let's not use Twitch Dono chat. Twitch gets like 70%. I veto that. You can use Twitch Dono if you want. I appreciate it, but you don't speak for me. I appreciate any bit of support. It is all good. Like, whatever's most convenient for you is fine by me. Okay. I think that's all the workshops I upgraded. Wahoo! Let me real quick just check my workshop. Hi, Graha! How's it going? No, target Graha. Hi, Graha. Where's the pet button? Here it is. Hi, Graha. He's getting away. Okay. Oh, there's Aerith. Aerith's back there from Final Fantasy VII. Ooh. Oh my God, that almost just got us halfway to ranking up my sanctuary. Which, by the way, if you don't know where I'm looking at that, it's the Isle Keeps index on the left screen there is how I'm seeing that. Did I send people out on expeditions too? Thank God, I'm so good at this. This will not give us XP, but it is good for materials. Perfect, okay. I love this mount. Aha, they're done. I was right. Oh, my animals. I'm not gonna check the animal menu because I know they're pissed off at me. I haven't been here in like at least a day, so I haven't fed them. I'm sorry. let's grab my crops, and then I promise we'll go back to gathering food ingredients. You have so many great mounts. It's because I spend so much more money on this game than I should. But thank you. I do have a lot of great mounts. I actually don't have a lot of the really cool mounts you can get by actually playing the game. A lot of the good mounts that I have are just store-bought. But you know, I've been catching up in a way that makes me excited, because I think I'm getting pretty close to the point where I'd be able to start doing some like real ass like content, mountain grinding and stuff. Maybe I'll take after Joy and just get really like ravenous about mounts at a certain point. My favorite is the Phoenix from the EX Heavensward fights. I haven't seen that one. Although, I am very excited for the Phoenix that they're gonna add to the new Rising event. I cannot wait to have that one. Okay, once I grab these, and also grab the leavings from my animals, I'm just gonna go back to getting ingredients. Because I don't want to detour too much, lest I actually forget what I need to get. Which I haven't yet. I still haven't forgot. I know I need to get Dommel meat and yak milk. And I actually think I have everything else. Why did I target Sam? Okay. I'll grab Sam's claws or whatever. Sam was over there. What the fuck is going on? Target this one. Target the big beast in my way. Here. Thank you. Krang. Yeah, you like my animal names, by the way? Some of them are still not named, but I have Mocha. Quartz Spriggan is not one that I came up with myself. I actually need to, I actually have less name than I thought I did. I think it's just because I caught a lot more than I initially had when I was more diligent about naming them. What are you doing? You're digging your feet into the ground. Stop. Get you out of there. Oh, that's Mario. Hi, Mario. Hold on. Hi, Mario. And we have Timmy, Tracy, Steven, Licorice, and this one is not... This is the species name. Hello, Mario. Timmy? And Tracy. Whoa, mine now. I just got an achievement. Cool. Okay. That should do it. Let's get back to it. Right, sea of clouds. Okay. So we'll need to switch to a battle job for this. So let me go back to Red Mage. I have my Manderville. It's so pretty. Okay. Let's find a Dommel. Pretty. Personal space, please. Whoa! Okay. That's a Gastornis. That's a Galecat. Windsprite. More Gastornises. Would it be Gastorni? Aha! Dommel, here we go. Okay. Die now. Oh! That was not a one hit. Okay. Does that give me... Oh, I got Dommel hides. Oh, I might need to switch to a different... Yeah, I'll just try. Oh, we got meat. Okay. How much meat do we need? I can't even remember. The amounts are what I forgot. Oh! Oh, we just needed two. Okay, cool. Awesome. Well, we got what we needed there. Alright. Chat, does anybody know where I could buy yak milk? If I can. I don't have to look it up myself. Yak store. Cool. Awesome. You need meat for a cake? No, this is not for the cake. It's a whole process. The crystarium. Oh, yeah. Oh, I think I remember that, actually. Okay. Let's go to the crystarium. Oh, I love when I get to go back to the crystarium. I miss this place. I don't have it as my home point because it's in another fucking universe. And so traveling from here to everywhere else is really expensive on the gill. But it is. What is up with my controller targeting right now? Okay. So let me... Where are we going? Aha! The markets. Oh, I love the Crystarium. Oh my god. Ah! I believe... The person I buy from is over here. Yeah, just the merchant. Andia? Hi, Andia. How's it going? Oh. You don't have anything. Bye, Andia. I don't want your worms. Armorer, arms merchant. Huh. Jeweler. Where the heck? Oh, material supplier. That makes more sense. Anonymous, thank you for the tip. I appreciate it. You were hiding from me, Vral. Yak milk. Here we go. Why do I keep saying yak? Let's just get the... No, let's not get the max. Holy shit. I forgot how much we need, so let's just get 20. Whatever. Yeah, that's fine. Okay. Well, now we can, I believe, start crafting. So let's get back to Linarian vibes. All right. So before we craft this little stew, this little soup we have going on, we will have to make flour and sour cream, which I believe I can quick synthesize. Yes, thank God. Okay, I can quick synthesize all these. So let me do that. Is this where you would bake a cake? The Crystarium? Maybe. I'm a never say never kind of gal. Okay, so we have enough, thank God. And let's make the milk. We make it a milk. We make it a milk. We're gonna have. Oh no! Ah! My gear. Ah! My gear. Okay, we'll have to fix that. We'll have to fix that. So funny. Okay. So we can make this, but let's not make it while we're about to, while my damn shorts are about to break. Okay. Where's a mender? Tanner Vokit, Materia Vendor, Materia Melder. Mender, here we go. Hi, Axel. Big lion guy. Thank you so much for being yourself. Oh my God. Yeah. Okay. This, yeah, there we go. Easy as that. Okay. Breath of the Wild, eat your heart out. It was just that easy. Why can't you be like this? Okay. So now we make it a thing. Let's make two and let's try to get it high quality. So we're gonna start with this. I'm going off of memory here. Okay, this should be about what I'm looking for. Oh, let's do innovation and waste not, I believe is what we wanna do. Okay, then basic touch. Oh my God, okay, well, that about did it. Jesus. Okay, well, let's do this then. Because I have all my synthesis options. Yeah, there we go. All right, easy as fuck. So let's just do that again. Start with this one. Okay. And we don't even have to do waste not. We just do this. Then the basic touch. There we go. And then, oh, okay. My other stuff is not fully ready, so let's just do basic synthesis. That might be all I need, yeah. It's the level gap is too big. We were a shoo-in from the get-go. All right, so now let's go back to Mordona and turn these in, and we can get our funny little book, hopefully, and then we start working towards the cake. We're not even an hour in. Rudy, stop. Oh, appraiser. I have so much cool stuff for you. Like two of these things. Yeah, that's it. That's all we need. Let's grab our dang book! Master Culinarian 3. I'm going off of memory here. So there is a small chance this is not the right one, but I'm not gonna look it up because I want to increase my risk versus reward ratio. And it was so easy to get more white scripts that I'm not too bothered. Okay, so let's read this. Nice! You learn multiple master culinary recipes. Like what, video game? Like what? Let's see. Master Recipes 3, King Cake, that's fun. Do we have it? The Nivea Cake! While not common amongst the poorer classes, many Eorzean highborn practice the custom of decorating a cake for family members celebrating their name days. Uh-oh! This is the cake that makes you bourgeoisie. Oh, shit. I didn't know that. That's okay. We'll make it anyway. Just don't judge me. Let's see. Oh, someone wants to know what barding is on my chocobo. I believe it's, hold on. Companion? It is. Bat Marion. I just typed that in say chat. Okay. Alright, so let's go to Charlene. While unfollowing now. Loved her content, but I just found out she made a name day cake for herself. Cute. Did I say cute? That is cute. It was funny. My brain is all over the place right now. Okay, so we need to get a Snurble berry. I have no idea what that is. Can I gather that? I cannot gather that. Can I craft it? I cannot craft it. What the fuck? Where would I get a Snurble berry? Oh, is that something I would have to like do gardening for? Oh no. This might have to be something we buy. They're master gathering. Oh shit. It may or may not require another book. I could maybe do that. I'm maybe not against that. Wait, what book is it? Which master? Yeah, it's a gathering book. I'm not super familiar with gathering scripts, but I assume if it's for a level 60 recipe, it might not be that hard. It's an Idleshire. Okay, let's which book is it though? Because it doesn't tell me what recipes are in there. Unless I already have it. Let's go to Idleshire and see how much it costs once people tell me the book. I assume it could just be book 3. It's the Tome of Botanical Folklore. Indravania? That's a different place people told me. Oh no, never mind. Dravania is Idleshire. Oh right, I was getting that confused with Rodzenhan for some reason. Okay. Well, let's see. Let's see. Script exchange. Would this be gather a script? Here we go. Materials, miscellaneous materia. Oh, hold on. Materials, miscellaneous. Bait tokens, no. Materia. Wait, when, would it just be in? Tome of. The NPC next to this lady has the master tome? Game Lona? No. I don't know. I don't know what I'm looking at here. Splendor's Vendor? Fieldcraft. Oh! Fieldcraft. Okay, got it. Oh, Blue Gatherer Script Token. Oh, I see. Okay, I see. Tome of Botanical Folklore, Dravania. It costs 5 Gatherer Script Tokens. Oh no. Watch, that's gonna be like 500, I think. If I had to guess. Level 60. No, this is for crafters. Bait and tokens. That's not even the, hold on. What the fuck? Oh, level 60. Blue gatherer script. Oh, it's 25. Oh, that's so doable, maybe. Oh wait, we can just get it right now. I have some left over. I didn't even know I already had 200 gatherer script. Oh, thank God. Okay, whew. Dodge the bullet. Here, let's grab this. Nice. Okay. Oh, that was so much easier than I thought it might be. They're really making you run a whole bunch of errands just to celebrate your own birthday by yourself. Yeah, but I mean, to be fair, a lot of this is because I've been playing this game for like over 3 years, I think, and I just haven't interacted with so many of these systems nearly as much as I should have. So it's kind of my fault. I could have done, because this is like, this is a Heavensward area. I'm like 3 or 4 expansions past Heavensward. I could have done this shit a long time ago, but I didn't. But I mean, that also just speaks to just how much there even is to do in this game in the first place, that I've been playing for over 3 years and there's this much stuff that I just haven't touched. Okay. So I actually don't know. I assume that just added new things to gather on regular gathering nodes, which makes sense because when you're looking at gathering nodes, I've always noticed that there are like these big gaps in the list. It makes sense that those could be filled with things that you would have to unlock to gather in the first place. That's pretty cool. I actually never knew that, but it is intuitive in that way. Well, that's, to be fair, that is also an assumption. That just makes sense to me. Kawaii Fallout, thank you so much for the Prime sub. I really appreciate it. Thank you, thank you. And thank you for the kind words as well. It means a lot. Okay, so... Right, now we have a way to get those Snurgle Berries, I think is what they were called. Let's look at what else we need. Highland Flower, which we actually have plenty of. That's great. Sweet Cream. We don't have plenty of that, but we can maybe just make more. That needs buffalo milk. I wonder where to get that. I assume any material vendor, maybe. Would it be the same as the yak milk? Maybe I saw it and I just didn't process it. Okay. Okeanisek. I don't know where. Okay, that's certainly not a... Yeah, that's not a gathering thing. That might be like a... Oh boy. That might be like a treasure map thing or something. Maybe we just have to buy that. We need bitch syrup and beeswax candle. What the fuck? A beeswax candle? I don't want to get any of this stuff. Okay. Hold on. Let's look this up. Okay. So, Okeanisek. It is not available for purchase. Oh, it's just an enemy drop. It's dropped by Okeanis. Okay, thank God. Okay, so that's just in the Dravanian Hinterlands. That's just something we can farm for again from enemies. Birch syrup. I need to check what we need to get in order to make that. Hold on. Birch sap. Oh, that should be easy. Yeah, that's just a gathering spot. Thank God. Okay, just a logging spot. And then beeswax candle. Let's look this up. We need 4. These can be bought from a material supplier in... Oh, Oh, in the housing wards. Interesting. Okay, so we can get one in Shirogane. That's actually awesome, because I was thinking of making the cake at my free company house and indulging in it in there. So, okay. So let's we have a bit of a game plan. So we need to grab Snurble berries and Okeanos eggs. Okay, we'll just go down the list. We'll just get what we need from the list. Let's get some Snurble berries, because that is delightful to me. Hopefully we should have it on the gathering method now. Yes, we do. Perfect. Okay, it is in Dravania, but it is unknown. We do know it's kind of in this area. Oh, I really hope it's not something I have to get from an unspoiled node. That would be a little bit of a bummer. Oh, right, there's no... God. The Heavensward zone design is really interesting, because we actually can't teleport to this area. We have to walk out from Idleshire. It's a legendary time node? Shit! Oh, no. Well, if push comes to shove, we can always just see how much it costs. I thankfully actually have some gil to my name right now, so. Okay. Where are we headed? I went out the wrong way. We gotta go, like, over here. Can I do, like, a... Shit. Can I do a flag pin on my... Oh, map link? Yes, here we go. Perfect. I just learned how to do that on keyboard and mouse. They just keep adding more steps. The steps were there to begin with. They didn't add shit. This is why I did this. This is why I did this idea. I was like, this should hopefully be enough for a quick stream, because I'm so behind on the whole crafting and gathering ecosystem. Oh, I gotta switch jobs. Hold on. Let me, Oh! Wait. Please tell me this is it. Please tell me this is it. If it was right now, right here, that would be so fun. So fun for me. Come on. Even if it's not the Snurgleberry one, I'll still grab it anyway, just for fun. Unspoiled mature tree. Okay, it's not Snurgleberry. We can get cloud bananas, though. That's fun. Whoa. Cool. I get a lot of morals in VeggieTales. No, that wasn't what I was gonna say. I get a lot of morals in Stardew Valley. Those funky little mushrooms. Okay. Sending me back. It doesn't want me over here. Oh my god, it really isn't up here. It's all the way down here. They were sitting right there. I passed them. I was like, these aren't the ones. They were the ones. I mean, not that I think these are Snurgleberries. But at the very least, I want to try. What are at these lush patch? Gathering tool paraphernalia. Yuck. That's so boring, man. Okay. Well, let's see when the next Snurgleberry is happening, because that Because thankfully there are websites that track these things for me. Final Fantasy 14 Snurbleberry spawn. Unspoiled folklore. Would it be folklore? Snurbleberry. Spawns at 10. It's 9 right now. Huh. Interesting. Oh, Final Fantasy 14 clock. Here we go. Oh, hey! Apparently, according to this website, we got one popping in like 13 minutes. So we can go work on other stuff, and then I'll have this open, and I can come back when it's time. Hopefully. Yeah. Okay. Cool. Wonderful. Also, thank you, Santa, for the $20 tip. I really appreciate it. Thank you, thank you. It means a lot. Okay. So in the meantime, let's work on some of the other stuff. Let me go ahead and get some of these eggs that are in the Dravanian Hinterlands. So, where are we right now? We are in the Dravanian Hinterlands. Okay, so we need to kill Oki. Oh, hey! We're right here! Oh, shit! Look at that! Lucky me. Let me switch to Reaper. You like my Reaper outfit? I do. Got the jammies and the headphones. Alright. I've been leveling Reaper lately. This class is genuinely so fun. It's so incredible. Everything about it fucks. Perfect. Oh, I need to switch back to this. Okay, only tails so far. Okeana's tails, woo! Every day they're out there making. Cool. 3 eggs, awesome. How many do we need? We should too. Perfect. Okay. This is already going a lot quicker than I thought. Okay. Casual sleepy gamer, thank you so much for the sub. I appreciate it. Wow. Okay. What next? We need birch syrup, which means we need birch sap, which means we need to go to... Uh-oh. Wait, what? Oh. There we go. Okay. I was like, I thought I saw this. Okay. We need to get some bitch sap for bitch syrup. So we go to Camp Loudtop is the closest. Yeah, like, look at the- This is the Heavensward zone design experience. They have 2 teleport points exactly parallel to each other, and then all of this space just without any way to get there, except manually. That's okay though. We're not against working for what we want. Okay. Let's do botany. And wow, another unspoiled mature tree. Cool. I'm not gonna worry about that for now. It's whatever. Let's go east. So pretty. It's very fun when doing the tribe stuff here. Oh yeah, no, for sure. This might be what we're looking for. They didn't really nail ease of zone traversal until Shadowbringers. Yeah, Shadowbringers and Endwalker have like much easier zones. Okay. Bitch sap? Bitch sap, here we go. Do I have my, hold on. Field mastery. Oh, I don't have the thing on. Bountiful harvest, that's not what I want. What do I want? I'm trying to do the giving land, bountiful harvest too. Look at the pioneer, blessed harvest. That's what I want, blessed harvest. This is going on my hotbar. Just like right here. Let's make things a lot easier. This just increases my yield from gathering by like one or two, I think. I don't know. I think it's two for the one I just assigned. So I'll just get a shit ton of these. Oh, I almost just clicked the birch branch, by the way. That would have been bad. Birch sap. Here we go. That should be enough, honestly. Let's see. We can cook here, it's fine. I'll cook in the water. Yeah, perfect. Easy, easy peasy. Do we have quick synthesis? We do not. That's okay though, we can just do this. Oh yeah. They should introduce a mode where you can't fast travel. Sounds terrible. Yeah. I've considered trying to play the game like that before just for fun. I think when I do a replay of the main story quest at a certain point, like the entire thing from the beginning, which is probably gonna be in chunks once they start doing graphics updates for them. What I wanted to do was sort of really get into the roleplay aspect of it and like limit myself and limit my mount usage to like flying only past certain points in the game. But like for A Realm Reborn, I was like, what if I just didn't use flying mounts the entire time? And then in like Heaven's Ward and all the early expansions, I just really early on just like didn't fly with my mounts for a certain point. Wouldn't be the most necessary thing, but I thought it'd be fun. And I also, because I often find late in the game now, I can just do quick synthesis while I'm talking about this. I don't know why I'm not doing that. I find now when I'm playing, all of the zones tend to feel a little bit more like synthetic when you can move around them as quickly as you end up being able to. So when I replay chunks of the story, I like to really kind of like take in the world from this angle, because when I'm able to just like fly and like just cut through everything like this, you know, you can really see like, oh, this is a video game map, you know. But like from ground level, everything has like a nice sense of scale to it, I think. So I think it would be fun to really immerse myself, for lack of a better word, in sort of the scope of the zones early on when replaying the expansions, but just like, you know, artificially limiting myself and going very roleplay. I'm very excited for that, because like, I don't know, when I was first playing through the early game, I did not take it nearly as seriously as I do now. And when I was playing, like, the difference between when I was playing A Realm Reborn and when I was playing Endwalker in terms of like the energy that I was giving to the story and my own sort of like roleplay of it, it was like night and day. So I really want to replay A Realm Reborn, Heaven's Ward. A Realm Reborn and Heaven's Ward especially, but also Stormblood to an extent. And like really give it kind of just like that attentive good spirited, like, attentiveness. I actually think that's a great word for it. Because, like, in Heaven's Word, I was, like, changing my glams based off of the areas I was going to. You know, I would, like, when we would go somewhere cold, I would snuggle up in a big coat. And, like, you know, whenever we... just, like, for every occasion, I just, like, I really changed up my look. And I was very into that kind of feeling like I was really a part of things. And I want to do that for the earlier stuff. Like, I literally... When I replay A Realm Reborn, I'm gonna have, like, a glam... Like, I've put together test glams for this before. I wanna have, like, this look. Like, this kind of look to begin with. Like, because, you know, it's got that simple, kind of, like, humble... early beginnings vibe, and I really would want to, like, kind of recapture that. You know, I don't want to walk in A Realm Reborn replay with, like, the prettiest, like, relic weapon and, like, you know... all geared up as if I've been doing this for years, because at that point in the story, you simply have not. Most likely. I don't know. I mean, everyone's character is their own. Also, look at this. It's awesome. Anyway. That's neither here nor there. I can't wait to replay it, though. I'm really excited for the graphics update, because that's going to be a really, really nice, like... Just a nice way to re-experience it, sort of remastered... How's the... Oh, thank God. Okay, so we got a couple minutes until the Snurbleberry note appears. So where are we headed? We're going to Onyx Trine? Onyx Trine? Position 3926, apparently, is where it is. I don't know. Actually, if we just hang out in this general area here. Oh, actually, this would be a good idea. Killing you 99. Thank you so much for the tip. I appreciate it. Thank you so much. All right. Wait, people are, okay. Oh, I see what they mean. Okay, so Onyx Trine, they said, is the best starting point. So if we were to... Oh, it's because this point is, like, right next to it, essentially. Okay, got it. So we actually are going to the Hinterlands. We're just taking it from here. How hard is it to get into Final Fantasy XIV? I really want to, but it seems like a lot. It seems like a lot because I'm really late into the game. I promise you, most of the shit that I'm doing right now is, like, not even a factor when the game starts. Like, you really, like, yeah, it, a lot of content does not unlock until you've played through the proper, like, story point in the main quest. Everything is tied to the main story, essentially. So if you're playing the main story, it's, like, a singular, straightforward narrative that you can play through. And just kind of enjoy. And as you play through that narrative, and as you level up with the story, you will get more opportunities to unlock more stuff as you go. It's really not, like, it's not so much to begin with. And it's free. It's free to start. So I would say just try it. If it interests you at all, just give it a shot. Can I take this off now? I don't want this anymore. Hey, it worked. Cool. Okay, so I assume 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Come on. Oh, here we go. Legendary Lush Vegetation Patch. Is this it? Snurbleberry! They were right! Oh, wait. This game is, like, linear? Yeah, it has an ongoing linear story that you play through. That is in its entirety when you start the game. Like literally, unless you go to the online store and buy a story skip, you cannot skip to later in the story. It plays essentially every expansion is kind of like its own like single player RPG with like an expansive online multiplayer thing built around it. That's a lot of snurbleberries. Also, the trial is endless. I'm not just saying this because it's the meme. Someone asked. The trial is infinite. And they're actually even about to expand it to include another full expansion pack. With the trial version, you can play the base game entirely for free with no time limit. And also, you get two full expansion packs on top of the base game that you can play through. That is literally hundreds, if not thousands, of hours of content completely for free. I feel like I go through this every time I play this game because everybody's coming in like, how do I get into Final Fantasy? And I gotta tell them. I gotta tell them. How do they call that a trial that makes the rest of the game expansions? Well, here's the kicker. Here's the kicker. The expansion right after the new one they're about to add to the free trial, the expansion right after that is arguably the best part of the game. So they kind of entice you with like all of the lead-in. And then if you get to that point and you enjoy the game enough that you would then buy Shadowbringers and expand to a full account, you are about to get into it's about to have its hooks in you like forever, like forever for the rest of time. Shadowbringers fucks. Shadowbringers is so fucking good. And Walker too. They work in tandem. Anyway. Okay. So back to Culinarian. Oh, we have so many snurbles. So we have snurbleberry flour. Oh, we need sweet cream. That's milk, right? We can go back to the Crystarium for that. And then we just head to Gugane. Well, I think we can go back to the Crystarium. Let's see. Let's check it out. This game, I'll just say, this game is not hard. There is some, like, extremely optional, extremely high-end content that is hard. But, like, the game itself and, like, 99% of the content in this game is not difficult in the slightest. It's just big. There's just a lot of stuff to do, and there's a lot of systems that intertwine. But again, they're all stuff that it eases you into. Bit by bit, essentially. Oh god, I love the Crystarium music. This is so nostalgic for me. Buffalo milk! I believe that's what we needed. Let's just get like 20 of these. Nice. Okay, let's see. Is that what we needed? Yes, perfect. Oh my god! Oh, I don't have inventory space. Ah! Shit! The damn snurbleberries. They got me again. I have to put some stuff away. We can do this real quick. Hold on. Thankfully, there is a retainer bell right here. Are there any aspects that you... Oh, hold on. Are there any aspects that you feel make it very compelling from a boss rating aspect for those who have done those? I like hearing people gush about this game. I have not personally gotten super into, like, the raid scene in terms of like boss raids and like high end raids. Most of the raiding that I do are the Alliance raids, which at a certain point are just autopilot essentially, because it's just a shit ton of people. Most of them so much more likely to understand the raid than you and like kind of carry you through it. And then, okay, cool. Oh no, this is not the right one. And then, you know, the other raids are like, how many retainers do you have? I don't know. As many as they'll let me. That's real. That's genuine. I'm telling you, I spend money on this game. Okay, can we put... Oh, we can put a lot of this stuff in here. That's good. How much of this shit is in here? Hello? Oh, I have all this space in here. I didn't realize. Okay. I was like, I had all this stuff in here already? How? Oh, I need my dart frogs. It's Frogust. Here. Let's put these in here. That's so much fucking material. Keeping the Fantasia. Put this away, whatever. I need to put the dyes in my Chocobo saddlebag. No, I need that. Wait, no, I don't. Never mind. Big seeds. I don't know what those are for. So. Okay, I can't put any of this stuff in here. So let me just see what else can go in here. Just in case there's something else I can. Inventory management is not my strong suit. Aha, we found one. Anything else? Ha 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 ha. Let's just see what we can add to the stacks. Oh, baby. Oh, we're doing so good, actually. Perfect. Anything else? Nope. Okay, that's fine. Let's back out of here. Are you waiting for the 6X patches to conclude to continue the MSQ or just enjoying the non-MSQ content more? Yeah, right now, it's just been the vibe to really sink my teeth into a lot of the other content that I've quite frankly neglected. And get into like a real flow before I get addicted to the main story again. And on top of that, I have also considered continuing the main story and doing all of the patch quests that I have left in a Midnight Snap episode. But actually, the more I think about it, the more I don't know if I'll do that specifically, just because I don't know how well that video would do because it's technically pretty spoilery. And also, if there's ever an exciting moment where I want to pop off, it would be a bummer to not pop off over the story of my favorite game. So, you know, we'll see. I do want to do Midnight Snap episodes for Final Fantasy though, because this game, I could just do entire like gathering and crafting episodes. Honestly, I think it would be such a vibe. Okay. Yeah, there's thankfully a wide range of content that could totally fit the Midnight Snap vibes more than MSQ. So since I'm reconsidering doing it for Midnight Snap, I am getting close to the point where I'm like, I'll keep it up. I could stream it, honestly. That might be fun. You can turn battle sounds off. Yeah, you can adjust like every kind of audio can be adjusted. It's got a pretty extensive audio menu, which is nice. I've been really enjoying Midnight Snap recently. Thank you. That genuinely means so much to hear. Every time someone's like, hey, this show means a lot to me, it's helped me a lot, I'm like, I gain like 2 years on my life. No, truly though, like it's been such a privilege that people have found that show enjoyable and helpful. Okay, guys, we're so close. We just gotta get the beeswax candle. Let's go to my house. this is the house of the free company Team Tizzup, which is the new name for my free company that I have with Katie and Joy and some other people. Katie did like all of the decoration except for the stuff that's in my room, of course. So, you know. Okay. Yeah, we got the Shirogane plot. We got the damn Shirogane plot. Okay. So, if people wanna, let me see. I mean, people are free to come by and visit if you want to share this cake with me. I'll just be making it. Oh, wait. What do I need to do first? Hold on. Let me go to... I've watched every Midnight Snap episode at least 2 to 3 times. That's awesome to me. Thank you. Thank you for telling me that. What is this music? What is playing right now? Gates of the Moon. Oh, okay. Look, it got better. Let's do What Angel Wakes Me. Yeah, here we go. That's better. What the fuck? Do What Angel Wakes Me. Yes, here we go. Got it. Okay, material supplier. Nope, not it. Cooking ingredients. What? It's not it. I could have gotten the damn buffalo milk from here the entire time. No, I don't want the... Which... What am I getting again? Beeswax candle. Oh... What the fuck? I don't know where to get this thing. Wait, is it maybe... Hold on. Is it maybe this thing? Scream. Oh, Axe Promptly! Hi! Thank you so much for the raid, everybody! Hello! We are just about to wrap up making myself a little birthday cake in Final Fantasy XIV. I don't know if that means we're wrapping up the stream. We haven't even been going for 2 hours, so I might find something else to do. I'm just trying to figure out how to get a beeswax candle. It might be from the NPC outside in the ward and not the one in houses. Oh. Let's figure this out. Oh, this is wrong door. I literally did the cartoon sitcom bit where I... walk in, like, I'm like, I'm leaving, and then I walk in the closet, and then I have to walk out and then walk back out the real door. Okay, where is this bitch? Oh, sorry. I didn't mean that. No, but yeah, I'm so... Housing merchant, here we go. I'm so glad to hear that Midnight Snap is not only enjoyable for people, but also, I don't know if this is the right one either, but also it has like longevity, like people can watch it like multiple times. That means so much to me. Come on, man. I be honest? I didn't know this damn place was here. I have never been here before. Junkmonger. I have never been here before. I didn't know there was a whole shopping district. This is awesome. Wait. Do you have visitors in the house? Yeah, come on in. Spoils Trader? No. I'm so confused, man. Sorry, I feel so silly. I could maybe just see if the market board has it. Yeah, that's still not it. Wasn't it the first time, and it remains not it. This is the housing merchant. This is the... Oh. Material supplier? Come on. She has beeswax. I need a beeswax candle. Okay, let's just see if the market board has it. She had it? Wait, did I miss it? She had the candle? It's like three down from the... Okay. Oh, thank you. Good lord. We did it. All right, let's head back to the house. I know generally where our house is because we're right next... We have next door neighbors with like the brightest pink roofs. Which is like valid as fuck. Anyway. Yeah, if you want to come visit... This is the Dizzy Hideaway. It's on plot 55, 24th Ward of Shirakane. Of course, I'm in Genova, so... if you want to come watch me as I make my birthday cake and come partake, here we go. Let's hope I don't fuck this up, because I don't know if I have enough ingredients for two attempts. Oh, I need four beeswax candles. Hold on. I already see people coming in. I appreciate it. Thank you, thank you. I just use my mount. I forgot I can use mounts here. Whoa! It's not the vibe. Sorry, guy. Oh, yeah. This is the vibe. Woo! Off the stairs. I love that. Hold on. Wait. Woo! Tricks. Okay. Do three more. Yeah! Let's arrive on my birthday balloons. Are you even making me want to get into Final Fantasy? Do it. I dare you. Oh, hi! Hello! Let's do this thing. All right. I should have everything now. Yes, I believe so. Okay, here we go. Oh, this, like, isn't gonna be hard. Watch this. Boom. Yeah. The level difference is a lot. Let's do a... Yeah! Hi, everybody. Hello. Okay. Here, let me show you my magic trick. All right. I think I can put the cake on this funny table. Let me see. Is it actually a housing item or is it... Oh, here it is. Yeah, this is a tabletop item. So I should be able to put it on here if there's room and everyone can feel free to partake. Oh, it's indoors only. Oh, no. Oh, man. Okay. Well, we'll figure this out. Come inside if you want. I wonder if you can. Are y'all able to come in? Oh, Katie just logged on. Yeah, people can come in. Awesome. Okay, so let's sit down right here. Okay. Can I do housing stuff from the seat? Perfect. All right. Let's play it. Right here. Awesome. Yes. Yoo-hoo! Oh, this is so cute! Oh, awesome. Well, everyone, I can't see shit. I might have to go like first person here, hold on. Everyone, thank you so much for joining me for this wonderful little moment. I have my cake in front of me. Can I like, hold on, can I do a... Wait, I might be able to simulate like kind of blowing out the... I might be able to simulate blowing out the candles, one sec. I might end up telling it to shush. Hold on. Where is it? It should be in general. This is a great song. Well, I'm gonna poke it. I'm gonna look out for it. And then, shush it. You gesture for the name day cake to be quiet. Katie, hi! Hold on, hi! All right, everybody. Everybody, please feel free to partake. We only have 10 slices, so sorry if someone doesn't end up getting one. Yeah! Aww, y'all are so sweet, thank you. Oh my god. Everybody partake. Hold on, can I do like a... I'm just gonna do a funny little dance. Oh, only FC folks can eat it. Oh, that makes sense. All right, well, thank you for coming anyway. Yes, Katie, get some. Yeah, yummy. Quick, we have to eat the whole thing. Oh shit, I wanna do my, hold on. Do I have my Rumorborn Red set to a, no, hold on. Let me, God, this is a great song for the occasion. I fucking hate my cheers so much, but it's kind of grown on me in a fun way. Also, I get to celebrate culinarian victory. We did it. We made my funny cake. Everyone cheers rancorously as Penny eats the entire cake. I haven't eaten the entire thing. I'm just gonna eat most of it. Hiya. I'm so well fed right now. Hi, yeah, yeah, yeah. I love everybody's look is so on point. Y'all look amazing, can I just say? Everybody's glam's stellar. Survived another year, revel in the triumph. I absolutely will. Thank you, Kira Cat. I appreciate it. What is this? Who put God in my free company house? Thank you, Kira. I appreciate it. All right. Well, I don't know what else to do now. This feels like the end of the stream, but like, thank you for the account, Chuck. Kagero, I appreciate it. You know what? Honestly, I did. This is just like Endwalker for real. That's true. You know what? I think I might end the stream here anyway. Let's just call it here. We had a fun time. I did what I set out to do. It wasn't as hard as I was hoping and kind of fearing that it would be. But that's kind of a blessing in its own right. And I can take the rest of the night to just hang out, do my own thing. So yeah, mission complete. Hey, thank you all so much for watching. I've had a great time tonight. I hope you have as well. It's been super chill, super good vibes. Like I said, I'm gonna do my absolute freaking best to be back to normal schedule on Tuesday. Whether that's with Metroid or with something else, I don't know. But I will be back to streaming on Tuesday to the best of my physical ability, even if it's a short one. So please look forward to it. We're gonna keep the ball rolling. I'm gonna do my best to get back on track. Been a rough couple months for the motivation and the energy and all that stuff, but I've had a great couple days. It was great seeing y'all here. I'm really glad that I did this tonight, even if it was kind of short. It was short and sweet, which is, there is room for that in my life right now. So have a wonderful rest of your night, everybody. Let me set y'all up with a raid. Let's keep the party rolling elsewhere, if y'all are so inclined. Currently, we got a few streams going on. Mars currently streaming Eye the Somnian Files, so sure, let's send y'all over to Markatoto. Good friend of the channel, Markatoto. Do we have raid phrase ideas? Thank you so much for the well wishes, everybody. I appreciate it a ton. Cake raid. I don't want it to necessarily. Bitch syrup is pretty good. We could do bitch syrup. What was that berry called? Oh yeah, no, do snurble berry. I don't want to post a lot of bitch in Mars chat for a raid. Do snurble berry. Snurble berry is a good raid phrase. Snurble berry. It's not snurgle berry. You can do snurgle berry if you want. Whatever. I really don't care that much. Okay. Just something with the berry. All right. All right, everybody. Thank you again, seriously. This means a lot. And also everybody showing up to the free company house. It's got my heart soaring right now. Y'all are so sweet. Thank you for doing this little celebration with me. I had a fantastic time tonight. And just thank you again just for all the support, whether it was tips or subs or anything, or even just showing up in chat. It really means the world to me, and I cannot express how excited and just glad it makes me that y'all are, you know, just with me and, you know, so supportive and honest to God right now, most of all patient in a way that I cherish it. I don't take it for granted. So yeah, I will see you on Tuesday, assuming a meteor doesn't strike my house. But until then, have fun with Mar, have a wonderful Monday. Have a wonderful rest of your week if you don't make it on Tuesday. And otherwise, just please take care of yourselves, because that's the most important thing, is that you're taking care, doing good by yourself and the people around you. And what else is there to say? All right. I'll see you soon, everybody. Bye.